Well, good afternoon. It is Long Haul Tanker, straight razor shaving with Long Haul Tanker. And day number two, exile, captivity. in Zanesville, Ohio, awaiting that long awaited, ever elusive phone call to go make delivery. A truck driver buddy of mine was up here about a month ago, and he ended up same place, same truck stop, same delivery point, and was here for 8 days on lockdown, you might say. I'd say lockdown, that invokes other images. No, just in waiting, driver in waiting for delivery, waiting for that phone call from security to come on up. Anyway, our equipment for today, let's see, 10 minutes after 12, March the 1st, 2022, and Zanesville, Ohio. Now, we're going to use, since I've reached the end of my 7-day rotation on the razor set that I've had with me for the last little while, once I've done that, I always consider myself to be in free use. I can use whichever razor and whatever order I want. Otherwise, I always follow a strict regimen because I love my razors and I don't want to show partiality. And I want to work through them in order, but once I've reached the end and I'm still on the road until I get home and switch out my roll-ups, it's free use. I can use whichever one I want to as often as I want. So we're going back to the Wade and Butcher that I honed up to the shaft and glass 30K, beautiful tortoise, imitation tortoise handles. It's a wedge razor, pre-1891. And it's just a beautiful razor. And after that last shave, it was just so wonderful. And I'm going to use it again and duplicate my efforts that I did. And so that I did on that shave a little while ago. Anyway, Savile Row, I think it's 3226. That sounds right. I looked it up. And we're also using and continuing to use the Sterling Black Cherry. Wonderful aroma. I have had the Puck jar soaking, had a nice hot shower. I'm going to load it up heavily. One thing I noticed on the last shave is that this Black Cherry likes to thin out pretty good as you move along through the passes in the shave. And so I'm going to load it up real good. And of course, I can always come back and get more if I want to. It's not a big deal. Had a good hot shower, got good hot water in the sink. If there was any negative about the shower room, it's the lighting. Instead of being right overhead, it's behind me up on the ceiling, and that creates for shadows and not having the best lighting for shaving is not only not good for camera production purposes, but just the shave itself, it just won't do. But anyway, that's good there. Wipe my forehead, it's still quite humid in here. There's a fan mounted on the same wall as the mirror, and so the fan is pointing that way. What I do is turn it up on high. I got it on medium. That way it'll bounce off the wall behind and come right back. Yeah, let's try that. All right, here we go. So, Wade and Butcher, Sterling soap, Wild Cherry, and Savile Row. That makes sense. That sounds like a pretty good combination. That sounds like a real good combination. So on day number two of lockdown here at the truck stop, no telling when that call will come in. And so I've got a refrigerator of food, though dwindling. But that's why I stopped here and made that phone call. As I did, because there's a nice Arby's here, and I think there's something across the street if I wanted to walk over there. And that's looking pretty good right there. And we're early enough in the day that we shouldn't have any interruptions and knocks on the door and that sort of nonsense. I don't know that I got a lot to talk about. I got notification late yesterday in the afternoon that my new QED Manturian Silver Tip 26 millimeter brush has arrived and waiting for me at home, and I'm very anxious to get my hands on that thing. Silky soft bristles. If you don't have one of these and you have a Manchurian Badger, maybe a Simpson or something else, and you say, well, I know about Manchurian Badger. No, you don't. I don't understand all the designations as far, why this is so soft, and you've heard me say before that this more resembles what I've got in my collection, more closely resembles what's called a High Mountain White, as far as being how soft it is. It is a 3-band, not a 2-band, from QED, which is different than most Manturians. That's just another one of those confusing points. All right, here we go. You may recall on my former video using this razor, using the 30 shafting glass 30,000 that I made reference to and pointed out that I was able to get a good bevel all the way down to about 1/8, 1/4 of an inch from the end of both the heel and the toe. But the thing just shaved so well that I'm not even going to try and make it better. It is so much better than what it was. Oh yeah, I had 48 hours of growth on there, just a little better, about 50 hours. And it was bristly, it was bristly. So I buzzed my head this morning with the clippers, and we'll do a head shave later. Very nice. Oh, very nice. So if you're watching me on YouTube, thank you and welcome for being here. If you like what you see, you like watching straight razor shaving, my little anecdotal stories on the road about truck driving and other such things, hit the subscribe and follow along. That might be interesting. I just talk about the daily driving events and driver safety, and I don't talk too much about a little bit, you know. I'll throw a little shout out to the Canadian drivers that put up the protests, you know, God bless you. The US drivers now that are forming up and making their way through from various points to converge on Washington, God bless you. You know, I could get more political, but I, you know, what purpose does it serve? Really? Yeah. The way the lighting is and my distance from the mirror, I'm not seeing much. I'm just going through basic motions and memory. Well, that's feeling pretty good. I'm all right with it. So with all the downtime that I'm having, waiting at the truck stop to make my delivery, I'm watching movies and series on Netflix. I started last night, I started a series called Vikings, Valhalla. And I think I've got 3 episodes left to go. I think there's 8 or 9 episodes, and I've got 3 left to go for today, and I'll find something else after that, of course. And if you're watching me on the Shaving Cadre, I say thank you. And if you're watching me on YouTube, go over there to Shaving Cadre, check them out, theshavingcadre.com. Good bunch of people. At least the ones that I've interacted with so far have been very, very pleasant and kind to deal with. Well, the temperature was approaching 50 degrees Fahrenheit when I was walking over, about 48, 49, I think, as I recall. And very pleasant outside, sunshine. Didn't have to put on my jacket. That's always a nice thing.
Yep.
That felt real good. You know, the important thing with all of this, I don't care how much time it takes, I don't care, you know, about what other people's preferences are or what other people would do or, you know, what they might think I should do. That's really what I mean to say. Just have fun with it. That's the important thing. Have fun with what you're doing. You know, the little nicks. You know, if I was a businessman, I'd be a little more concerned about, you know, putting on a white shirt and I shaved with a straight razor and I nicked myself a couple of times and, you know, I wouldn't want that. And so I would have to figure out what I'm doing wrong or figure out how to do it differently so I don't end up with little nicks and blood spots all over my white shirt. I get that. I used to wear a white shirt and tie to work every day for 20 years. I didn't know anything about wet shipping back then. And so I came to straight razor shaving here just about six and a half years ago. And I'm driving a truck by then. And I still care, not as much as you might. Feels real good. All right, let's wash it off and see how I've done. And we'll clean it up, call it quits. Because of the lighting, and I can't see. I'm going to step out of camera for a second, do this sideburn. Yeah, that's good enough for today. I did do the head buzzing with my clippers, and so that makes it harder to see the short. That's good enough too. We'll let that go until a couple of days from now when I get some growth on it and I can see the whiskers sticking out a little bit better. But right there, I think that's, let me get a spot over here. All right, we'll let that go. We're going to call it. and that's it. After I get done with my head shave, I will wipe my face down with the Osma Alum block. And when I get back to the truck, I'll use one of the 9 aftershaves I carry with me in the truck. Most of them, not all of them, are Hanad brand. All right, so Wade and Butcher pre-1891 wedge, approximately, it's between 6 7/8. I don't think it's a full 7/8, but it's a good size razor. I think it's bigger than 6/8 though. So there's that. Savile Row, I think it's, 3226, maybe 28. I'm not sure if it's 26 millimeter or 28 millimeter, but I looked at them last night, yesterday, and the handle is the Savile Row 32 model. So, and I think it's either 3226 or 3228, not sure. Don't remember. What else? Oh, Sterling Black Cherry, delicious. It smells like you could almost eat it. All right, so that's it. I'm done. Day 2 in exile in Zanesville, Ohio. I'll see you down the road. Bye.